The golf swing is very demanding on the back, especially when you think about X factor, which is the separation from the upper body and the lower body, which really creates a lot of strain on the lower back.
During the backswing, I'm just really focusing on turning with my bigger muscles and really just loading up as much as I can to create power with my back and upper body, and then just unleashing it all at once during the downswing. During a typical week, I can probably hit well over 1,000 balls, probably a few hundred a day.
We know that there's somewhere in the neighborhood of 29 million golfers in the United States. We also know that somewhere in the neighborhood of 83% of these golfers are over 40 years of age, and about 59 or 60% are over 50 years of age. We also know that there's a pretty good relationship between having back injuries and golfing. So what we're doing here at the Spine Research Institute is trying to understand the relationship between playing the game of golf and what happens mechanically in your spine. How does that lead to back injuries?
All right, Grant, so we've got some equipment on here that we're going to use to help create a personalized model of you. And all of these different sensors are going to allow us to collect exactly what you're doing during your golf swing. And what we do is we bring all this information together to make a personalized model to understand what kind of loads are on your spine during this action. And what we're going to focus on is what is going on inside of your lower torso. If you look in the model here as you go through the swing, the red arrows are basically showing the loads on your spine. So the loads on the different discs and parts of your spine. The blue arrows are actually showing the forces that are developed in your muscles as you go throughout the swing. So you can see right before you make contact with the ball, you see all the arrows just kind of blow up. And what that's showing is that you have a lot of force generating in your muscles, which is then translating into forces in your spine itself. The larger the arrow, the larger the force. So what we're seeing here is that your spinal loads during this swing are going above the threshold where, for some people, there may be some danger. And this threshold depends on your age, your gender, a lot of different factors.
Bill, in your opinion, what do you think is the biggest danger zones or injury areas that you see in the back from the golf swing?
So we know that twisting is a very significant risk factor for the back. And we know it's exacerbated when you're twisting while you're bending forward like you do in a golf swing. And the results we've seen from the study of Grant have shown that there are enormous loads that could occur on the back when you swing with that kind of power. Throughout his swing, you can see there's a lot going on here. There's a lot of torsion, there's a lot of twisting, and what we see are some of these discs turn very, very red, which means there's a potential there for injury. The value of understanding causal pathways or how injuries occur is, if you understand how they could occur, you can understand how to fix them or how to prevent them, and that's what we do here.